Well, Walmart is famous for rolling back its prices to provide consumers with quality products at competitive prices. But it turns out that while the company was protecting consumers' pocketbooks, it was not doing the same for the environment. The company has pled guilty to criminal charges of dumping hazardous waste in 16 counties across California. Walmart will now pay more than $81 million in fines for negligently disposing of waste. The illegal dumping of fertilizers and other hazardous material occurred between 2003 and 2005, but it took nearly a decade, 20 prosecutors, as well as 32 environmental groups for Walmart to plead guilty in a San Francisco court. State investigators caught wind of the dumping when one of them witnessed a Walmart employee pouring bleach down the drain. Walmart said those employees were improperly trained to handle the hazardous material, but this is not the first time that Walmart has been accused of such crimes. For more, I'm joined now by Bob English. He's a producer at Prime Interest, and Rachel Curzius, RT producer. Thank you both, sir, for joining me.
Great,
so,
there
we go. Rachel, let's start with you. Go into greater depth about what exactly happened and what Walmart pled guilty to.
Sure. So Walmart employees essentially were getting rid of hazardous materials, things like fertilizer, bleach, nail polish remover, things that are proven to have a bad effect on the environment. And they were disposing of them by, as you said before, either pouring them down the drain, putting them into trash bins, or otherwise just putting them directly into the sewer system. So these goods were generally damaged goods, products determined to have bad packaging, things of that nature that they were unable to sell. So instead, they were just disposing of them in a way that the government deemed reckless, and actually in a way that the government deemed violated 6 counts of the Clean Air and Water Act in California, in those 16 California counties, as well as in Missouri, 1 count of violating the federal insecticide, fungicide, and rodenticide act.
All the very big words. Bob, Walmart's first quarter revenue for 2013 was $114.2 billion. What does $81 million realistically mean to a company that makes this much money? Does it mean anything? And does the crime fit the punishment here?
Well, of course, the $81 million is just pennies in the bucket for Walmart. They have a ton of cash, like you said, $114.2 billion in revenue. But their long-term problems are being actually solved by this. When you have these legal settlements, and we're seeing this in the banking industry too, these banks are getting rid of their reps and warranties problems. These settlements are a boon because they allow this 8-year process to come to a close. And in the bigger picture, I would ask, why is it possible for a corporation to be filed criminal charges against it? I mean, corporations are not people, are they?
I would say that the Supreme Court would say that they are, Bob.
This is just my personal opinion, and I'm going on a philosophical rant here. But corporations, you know, are made of people. People violated the law. Why is the government not going after the people who did these?
Well, on the other side, the government is going after the corporation that did not have the leadership the leadership that allowed people to not be trained to properly get rid of these hazardous materials that they knew they were selling. And in addition,
and the leaders are people, right?
Sure, the leaders are people, but they work as part of a larger institution. And certainly I could understand why you're saying, you know, this $81 million is ultimately coming out of shareholder money, right? There isn't actually
sure.
any money coming from the people who are making these decisions.
And
that way,
time.
I agree with you, no jail time. But one thing that is significant about this settlement versus a lot of the other financial settlements that we've seen is that Walmart did plead guilty. When we look at what a lot of the financial institutions have done, they've been able to settle for, you know, a certain amount of money, millions, even sometimes billions of dollars, but they've never had to admit wrongdoing. Which means that none of their crimes have really been investigated or put on the public record in a meaningful way, meaning you're just setting it up to happen again. In this case, the fact that Walmart did say that they were guilty means that they've acknowledged that this is a problem, and that if it happens again, there'll be even more intense punishment for them.
But this is not the first time that this has happened. Now, Bob, obviously Walmart, as Rachel said, has pled guilty and agreed to that settlement of $81 million. Is this an example of government regulation at work?
I don't think the government regulation is working. The Environmental Protection Agency is another revolving door bureaucracy. We see the same people heading in and out of all these agencies, and it's really a failure of the public trust that we give these entities that are supposed to actually protect people. They oftentimes do the opposite. They just give cover for large corporations to go about their business as usual. I mean, what we saw with the BP oil spill, the Deepwater Horizon in the Gulf, was there was a $70 million artificial cap on liability. Now, what did that encourage BP to do? Take on excessive risk.
Now, let's play devil's advocate here for Walmart. There was no specific environmental impact that was found in order to be related to these types of dumping that happened in 16 counties. So should there have been a crime at all? Should they have admitted to a crime if there was no evidence?
Well, there was certainly evidence that they were dealing with hazardous materials.
But no evidence that they were actually causing harm.
Right, but the crime that they committed wasn't necessarily that they caused harm. It was that they violated the Clean Air and Water Act, and that they violated the Insecticide, Fungicide, and Rodenticide Act, meaning that they improperly handled all these hazardous materials, allowing for the potential of there being an environmental impact. So it was that kind of risky behavior that they were deemed breaking the law, and that they acknowledged, listen, we plead guilty to this, but to go back to your point, mm-hmm. Bob, about the EPA, what's really fascinating is that the way that Walmart has decided to handle this in terms of, you know, this new training that they're having to make sure that employees are dealing with hazardous waste is that they actually now have a part of their company that's filled with former EPA employees, which, you know,
not surprising.
Yeah, it speaks to that revolving door. So these former EPA employees are helping determine exactly what Walmart's policy should be moving forward.
And to get them out of a jam, perhaps.
RT correspondent producer Rachel Curzius and Prime Interest producer Bob English, thank you guys for joining me.
Thank you.
Glad to be here.